Over 300 teams start the season with hopes of making it to the NCAA tournament, but only 64 lucky teams received an invitation. These teams start their journey down the road to the Final Four in today's game between the Yale Bulldogs and the Michigan Wolverines. This is where both teams wanted to be, Dick. Let's not wait any longer to get this one started. The Wolverines are in for what should be an easy one tonight, Dick, but how do they stay interested enough to win this game?
Interested enough, Brad. They still have to do the following things. Number one, I look at the point guard to step up tonight and really take control of his clock. Next, take care of the rock. No turnovers, baby. Turnovers only lead to easy scores the other way. Third, you gotta pound the board. Boards lead to wins, baby.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. The high screen.
That was awesome, baby.
Both teams looking to get things going here.
Trying to get that ball moving, get a good spacing.
For the bucket, the Bulldogs have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Inside. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
He's got an open look for the shot. Way off target. Inside. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He rips the nets for another score.
He's absolutely unconscious.
He'll regroup the offense. Number 34 receives the pass. He makes a nice shot fake. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Man, he ran his man right into the screen to get off that nice jumper.
They'll work it around the arc. He launches a three. The shot won't fall. Number 22 is feeling great out there right now.
Well, you know, Brad, these student athletes play with fire and emotion. You rarely see that in the pros.
He looks for three. Off the rim and no good. Trying to pack it inside. Turnaround jumper. Can't get the shot to drop. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets.
Right there, they missed him inside. You got to get the ball when a guy is open. That's a special art, feeding the post.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline.
That's battledore defense. Nobody coming over, nobody giving any help. I mean, that's how you see better defense on a playground.
The center handles the pass.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
They get it out into transition.
I sometimes wonder what it would be like to be a skywalker, elevating and throwing it down, Mr. Nessler. How much fun would that be?
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. They have to start making some crisper passes, Dick.
Yeah, these guys are going after everything, Brad.
The shooting guard handles the feed from the baseline. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
Bed the low block, and there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? As you would say right here, Mr. Vitale, Flop City!
I tell you one thing, absolutely a flop. No doubt, Mr. Nessler.
Number 15 receives the ball. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Shows patience waiting for the reset. They're working around the perimeter. He pump fakes. He looks for the bomb. Drains the shot.
That's nine unanswered.
On on the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from the top of the key. Way off target. Work it inside. That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, both teams seem to be playing very conservative. We're still waiting for one of these teams to throw the first punch, guys.
Gave it up. Takes the shot. Michigan are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Start things up again. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
He attempts the three. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it.
On the dribble, gives it up.
Great anticipation defensively.
He keeps the dribble as they reset. He wants a three. Off the rim and no good. Job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Moving it around the perimeter.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
On the outside, he takes a three, way off target. Trying to draw the foul. Too much contact there, and knocked him off balance a little.
High post screen, gonna use it.
And he scores despite the hack. Gave it up.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach.
He got the bucket and the foul.
Hey, the foul in the act couldn't stop him, baby. He wanted that bucket.
Now check him out. Who would have thought? With the cheerleaders. Come on.
Hey, he's out of control, Brad. He wants everyone to get up and enjoy the moment, including the cheerleaders.
To the line. May's rage has become such an essential part of Michigan athletics. This is when the student body is urged to wear a specific color in support of their team.
It's called a maze out game, Brad. Sometimes it's blue, other times it's white or yellow. It all depends. Regardless, I love it, Brad.
Fake. Goes up for two. Doesn't go. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up.
Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Number 22 is called for the foul. First personal foul. Didn't like what he saw in the post and reverses the ball. High post flashes for the opportunity. Went away from the post and goes the other way. Top of the circle, they gets the rejection. 15, grabs it.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
Looking for the foul. They really seem to be letting this one get away, Dick.
Yeah, there's been a breakdown somewhere. They need to talk this one over, Brad.
Now they'll bring it up. He shoots from long range. Off the rim and no good. The skip pass is picked off. This is great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
He up fakes. Gets it back out. Boy, it's all elbows and shoulders down there, and I think the defense is winning, Dick.
I tell you, doing a great job of post defense. A lot of people don't realize that is an area that has to be taught, and this kid has responded in a positive way.
He shoots from the top of the circle.
Shot was no good, baby. Beautiful use of the screen, though.
Number 34 with the fake. Fakes it. For the bucket, and off the mark. Shot clock is dead. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He pulls the trigger. The Bulldogs have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brady's on fire.
From way outside. And he misses the shot. At halftime, the Wolverines lead by 11. Yale seemed to have caught the turnover bug in that first half, Dick.
And that was big, and it bit them hard. You can't put points on a board if you turn the ball over. They better hope it doesn't come back to haunt them.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Dick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, you think?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle there.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
Looking for a good shot from three-point range. You bet.
How about a replay, boys?
Both teams are looking to get something going here. The power forward with the ball. For the deuce.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby. The frustration right there.
They work the perimeter. Wide open for the shot. He rejects it. The shooting guard gets the ball. Sets a screen for his teammate. The shot's off target. And working around the perimeter. He shoots from downtown. He drains it. Had a guy in the post, but elected to reverse the ball. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Here's a nice face up down in the low block.
Oh, he did a great job face up and then just attacked him and took it to the basket.
He can't shake the pressure. The center gets the pass. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Puts it up. Yale are on a run right here as of late, Dick.
Yeah, they've started to put it together on offense. Can they keep it together, though? That is the question.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip.
Step out on that screener.
He faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Tries for two. And he missed. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. A defensive player beats him to the spot.
Steals the pass. Pushes it up. Pump fakes. Controlling the ball. Takes the outside jumper. Sinks it. The Wolverines lead by 9. He was applying great pressure defense. Went for the steal, but he wound up with a personal foul instead.
Glad that's what happened when the defense is too aggressive and looking for the steal.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And he made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Double team now, bad angle.
The power forward takes the feed for two.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
From left of the circle, way off target. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. There's the trap.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Leans in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. On the outside. He lets it go. Off the rim and no good. The power forward takes the pass. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post-play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Brad and Dick, what a turn of events down here on the sidelines. The coaches and the players, they are feeling the heat. The message from the bench, defensive stops and do it now.
Goes up for two. Perfectly executed.
Show me that one again.
Gave it up. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on the post play.
Takes away the pass. From the top of the key, rims out. Number 00 is pounded on his way up. Dick, look at this. He's not afraid to let anyone know how he feels.
Oh, Mr. Nestler, that's a no-no.
He goes to the line for the first time. First one is no good. Sinks it. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right times.
He puts it in with contact and all. Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there. That'll take some pride on a defensive end.
For the bucket. Oh, yes. This crowd will go crazy if they get a shot to go down here. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper.
Up it inside.
And now the fadeaway jumper. In and out.
No matter how you describe it, a stop here will excite all of the fans.
Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket. Hey, this crowd will be ecstatic if they can get a basket.
Takes the pass in the paint. Here they come with a double team to stop it. Number 15 is charged with the foul. First personal foul. And we get a look here at our foul and timeout situation.
Hey, Brad, many games are lost because coaches fail to manage the clock. Possession or timeout situation. Let's see how these coaches fare tonight.
Hits the second. That makes it a four-point lead.
These kids are here to fight, Brad.
Dribble, gives it up. He shoots from downtown. He gets the bucket. This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. He puts up the tray. Off the rim and no good. Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their players down. I'm sure they're anxious, and they may be a little frazzled. Let's see how it all works out, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie. Back to the live action we go. Comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you gotta have a post. Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior.
Look at the number of points off turnovers.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
He strokes it. Yes! See who will benefit the most out of that timeout, Dick. He launches a three.
Foul them early and give your team a chance.
And now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? Stops the clock again.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
Sometimes a stat that gets lost, Dick, turnovers, and that can kill you in a ball game.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team's performance. If you give teams easy baskets, you got no shot to win.
There's a double team waiting there. They continue to foul to stop the clock. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
It's good. Makes the second shot.
They need a basket here to turn this into a one-possession game.
He fires away. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots killed chemistry, Brad.
Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, I tell you, they won this game, Brad, when you look at it and analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Bulldogs played exactly the type of game they need to get past their first-round opponent.
Mr. Nessler, if they can execute the way they did today, are you kidding me? Nobody will stop them heading into the second round.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.